فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الله تبارك وتعالى يسند القرآن: فلما آسفونا انتقمنا منهم فأغرقناهم أجمعين. Allah says, when they opposed our commands, when they went against the Prophet we sent to them, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, فَأَغْرَقْنَاهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ, all of them we drowned them. And if they become one who leave off the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they leave off the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they go against his speech, and they go against the messenger that was sent to them, they can be the most honorable of people. But then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will make them the most humiliated people, and Allah will put them down. He changes it with another set of skin so they may taste the severe punishment of the hellfire. Who's able to bear the punishment of the hellfire? Brothers and sisters, a lot of us, we complain about how much suffering and how much hardship we go through in life. We complain that things don't seem to be going the way we want it to go. But what we've really forgot is the problem isn't from nowhere else except ourselves. We're only suffering, we're only going through hardship because of that which our hands have put forth. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he destroys a nation based on their actions. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he lifts a nation based on their actions. Allah does not oppress. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will never oppress. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says to us in the Quran, فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةٌ أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. They should be very cautious. Those who oppose the affairs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they go against that which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala ordered them. They go against that which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told them to do. They also even go against that which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them to do. What will happen to them? And تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةٌ. Trials and tribulation will afflict them. أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Or they will be afflicted with a severe punishment the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has a methodology. Allah has a way. And that way of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is that he will destroy a people who oppose his commands, who go against the command of the messenger in which he has sent. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, فَلَمَّا آسَفُونَ انْتَقَمْنَا مِنْهُمْ فَأَغْرَقْنَاهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. Allah says, when they opposed our commands, when they went against the Prophet we sent to them, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, فَأَغْرَقْنَاهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ, all of them we drowned them. Allah is talking about the people of Nuh alayhi salam. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala also says, فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ. Every nation, they will be held account for their own actions, things that they have done. Allah is holding them account for that only. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ حَاصِبًا وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَخَذَتْهُ صَيْحًا وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضِ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَغْرَقْنَا وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. Allah mentions the different types of punishment he brought each nation. And after he mentions each type of punishment he brought each nation, after that Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ, Allah is not one, لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ, Allah was not one that oppressed them, وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ, but they were the ones who oppressed themselves. They went against the commands of Allah. They oppressed their souls in committing sins. Brothers and sisters, wallahi, if we stand up for the command of Allah, if we do as he tells us to do, we will live a good life. قال تعالى, Allah says, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا, if the people of the village, they believed in Allah, وَاتَّقَوْا, and they came with the piety and the God consciousness that was needed from them, Allah says, لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ, we will open for them, بَرَكَاتٍ مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ, we will open the blessings for them from high above, وَالْأَرْضِ, and we will also bring crops from the earth for them, we will make them live a good life, وَلَكِنْ كَذَّبُوا, but the problem is that they turned away from the command of Allah, فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Allah says, we held them account for that which they have done, that which they have put forth, and that is the result of their actions. It's the result of their speech and how they dealt with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's commands. Ya qawm, O people, when will we realize that the problem is from ourselves? When will we come to our senses and realize that Allah is only making us suffer? Allah is making us suffer in our own households. Allah is making us suffer on a large scale because of that which we have put forward. Brothers and sisters, when the day of Qubrus was being opened, the Muslims were opening it. A Sahabiyul Jaleel, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Abu Darda, he started to cry. And when he cried, they asked him, "Why are you crying, Abu Darda?" He separated himself from everybody else. He sat alone and he was asked, "What is it make? What's making you cry?" "Ma yubkika fi yawmin a'azza Allahu fihi al-Islam wa ahla." "Why are you crying for today? It's a day which Allah has honored the Muslims. Allah has honored the believers. Why are you crying?" And then he said, "Wayhaka ya Jubayr. Jubayr, destruction be to you. Ma ahwan al-khalqa 'ala Allah idh hum taraku amra bayna hiya ummatun qahiratun zahiratun lahumul mulku." تَرَكُوا أَمْرَ اللَّهِ فَصَارُوا إِلَى مَا تَرَى. He said, the people, look how much in need they are towards their creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if they become one who leave off the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they leave off the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they go against his speech, and they go against the messenger that was sent to them, they can be the most honorable of people. But then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will make them the most humiliated people, and Allah will put them down. So this great noble Sahabi, Abu Darda, is looking at the people and he's saying to them, today you might be those who are honorable, you might be gaining something which you're looking for, but the reality is, how close are you guys to humiliation if you go against Allah's command? If you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will humiliate you in this earth. Imam Ahmad, he narrated in his Musnad, من حديث أم سلمة رضي الله تعالى عنها قالت, she said, I heard the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم say, إذا ظهر المعاصي, if the sin prevails on this earth and it starts to show, في أمتي, in my ummah, عمهم الله بعذاب من عندي, Allah will place over them a punishment from himself سبحانه وتعالى. فقلت, I said, O messenger of Allah, أما فيهم يومئذ أناس صالحون, is there not amongst them that day righteous people, people who fear Allah, people who worship Allah, are they not amongst them that day? قال بلى, the messenger said, yes, of course they are. فكيف يصنع أولئك, what are those people going to do that day, or what will be done to those people that day? There are amongst them righteous people. The messenger said, يصيبهم ما أصاب الناس, what will happen to them is that which happens to the rest of the people. ثُمَّ يَصِيرُونَ إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانًا, and then they will be taken to the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this hadith tells us that if the sin prevails and it shows on the earth, the ones who are worshipping Allah, their worshipping will not benefit. The punishment of Allah will encompass everybody. The one that is worshipping Allah, his good will only benefit him alone. Ayyuhal Muslimun, O Muslims, wherever you are, remember that you are a piece of the bigger picture. Wherever you do, you're contributing towards the destruction of Allah coming close. Fattaqullaha, fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, privately and alone. Fear Allah in public when everybody can see you. Know that you will be held account for every single thing which you say. We've become those who only know Allah by our utterance and our speech, and we've forgotten him subhanahu wa ta'ala in our actions and the way we live. We have forgotten Allah privately and when we're alone and no one can see us. We have forgotten Allah tabarak wa ta'ala even when we're on the streets now. We are not shy. We are not shy of him subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاسْتَحْيُوا مِنَ اللَّهِ حَقَّ الْحَيَاءِ, be shy of Allah the way he deserves to be shy of subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the most merciful. Allah is the most kind towards his creation. But Allah also is one who is able to destroy every single one who goes against his command. Fear him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give him that which he has commanded you to come with. Do as he told you subhanahu wa ta'ala. And wallahi, it is in your own personal benefit. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he told us, those who are the disbelievers, those criminals who went against the command of Allah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, كُلَّمَا نَضِجَتْ جُلُودُهُمْ بدلناهم جلودا غيرها ليذوقوا العذاب. Every time their skin peels and it goes, Allah تبارك وتعالى, He changes it with another set of skin so they may taste the severe punishment of the hellfire. Who's able to bear the punishment of the hellfire? Who is the one who can endure it? Wallahi, there is not amongst us anyone who can. No one can't. Our skins cannot bear it. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us that the people are one of two. Either you are fariqun fil jannah, you're a path that enters jannah and goes there, or you're going to be fariqun fil sa'ir, a people who are going to go to the destruction and the torment of the hellfire. نسأل الله الثبات على الحق والعزيمة على الرشد. O Muslims, wake up. Leave this long dream of yours that you guys are in. And remember, there is a day that we're going to stand in front of Allah. ليس بينك وبين الله ترجمان. Between you and Allah, there is no translator. No one is going to translate between you and Allah. You're going to go and look towards your right. And you're not going to see إلا ما. You're going to look towards your right, and guess what you're going to see? You're only going to see the actions that you have put forward. And then you're going to look towards your left, and you're going to only see actions and that which you have put forward. And then you're going to look in front of you, and then you're going to see the hellfire awaiting you if you haven't prepared well. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us, the Prophet said to us, ittaqun nar, fear the hellfire, walau bishaqqi tamr, even if it's the slit of the seed that's inside the date. Fear the nar, even that small size, because there is no one who can bear it. The people have to realize this. These are narrations and reality that the people are going to go through the day of judgment if they don't remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the one who created the heavens and the earth, the one who's going to resurrect us from our graves, the one who's going to account us the day of judgment, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He shows us His mercy and that He forgives us for our small sins that we commit. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ.